In today's video, I'm going to share with you 5 automated tasks that you want to add into your workflow when using Illustrator heading into 2020. Now, before we start, remember, if you want to excel as a graphic designer, do subscribe to this channel for weekly graphic design content. Now, briefly, what are automated actions in Adobe Illustrator? Now, essentially, we can record a process or a function and then simply play it every single time we want to perform that process in the future. This is going to save heaps of time in the long run, and if you still don't understand what automated functions are, simply follow along today and I'm sure you will understand after the video. Now, you can find the Actions panel under Window and Actions, and as you can see, I already have a new folder set for my 2020 workflow. Now, to create a new set of actions, simply click here. You will also notice that we have some preset default actions that Adobe has made for us, and some of these are pretty handy, such as the Pathfinder functions and also the file format saves. But to go ahead and create one of your very own actions, simply come up here and then click New Action. Now, I'm first going to show you how we can scale any design or object with just one single click. So the first action will be scale up by 50%. Now, since I've made a new action, Illustrator is now recording every single move I make. So if I come over here and then click the scale button, I can type in 150%, which will increase the object by 50%. If I typed in 100%, that will keep it exactly the same. Now that the scaling has been complete, I can click the stop button here in the actions window, and then Illustrator will save this process I've just conducted. Now, if you click here, you can see each of the steps within the process that was just saved. And clicking play while the circle or anything is selected will actually automatically increase the size of the shape by 50%. However, in the actions panel, there is a column here next to the ticked column. If you click this, then Illustrator will not skip by each step, and that's going to allow you to change details. So for example, if I don't want to increase the size by 50%, I can change the size of the scale accordingly. So that is the rundown of the basics of the action panel. But let's go ahead and make some more actions that are going to be very helpful for your graphic design workflow. So now we're going to make a complex action that's going to allow us to take a design, say for example a logo, and then duplicate it to different scales so we can test the design at different sizes. Now, Illustrator is recording my actions, and I'm going to copy this shape with Command or Control C, and then duplicate it over the top with Command or Control F. Now, Illustrator is keeping tabs of my actions in the Actions panel, as you can see. I will then come up to Object, Transform, and then Move. I will use 0 as the angle to keep it on the same plane, and then move it over to the right by 200 pixels. Finally, for this action, let's double click the scale window again, and I will this time scale down the shape by 60%, and then click stop to save the action. Now, because the size of the shape or your design becomes less and less, we're going to want to edit the amount that we move it to the right. So let's click that second column like we did before, so we can make changes as we go. It's also handy to know that you can come into the playback options here, and if you choose step by step, Illustrator will allow you to make those changes. But if you choose accelerated, it's just going to breeze by them all. So let's go ahead and use our actions on the smaller design here and choose a lesser amount for the movement. 150 pixels should be a good number for the second action, and I'm going to keep performing this function over and over. Like I said, this is great for things like logo designing, as it's always wise to test your logos at various different scales. And with this action, you can easily and quickly achieve this precise scaling. So let's move on to the third action for my Illustrator workflow of 2020. This one is quick, but it's an asset to my workflow, and I think it's really ideal. So I have two shapes here, and I'm going to need the Pathfinder window open. This action is going to be a keyboard shortcut for making compound shapes. Now, if you don't have a single clue about compound shapes, I suggest you watch my video, linked down the description box below after this one. But this time, in the actions panel, I'm going to make a keyboard shortcut of Command and F6. Illustrator is again recording my moves and my actions, so I'm going to go ahead and make the compound shape here in the Pathfinder flydown menu. So now I have a compound shape, and as expected, the group selection tool will allow me to move around the individual shapes. So reverting back to the two shapes, I can select them and press the keyboard shortcut of Command and F6, and this results in a compound shape. So I can do this at any time with a selection within my workflow. I just need to press Command F6, and I do use compound shapes quite often, so this is really, really neat. Now the penultimate action in today's video is one that you cannot find in the default actions, but I feel it should be there, and that is saving your designs as PDFs. So let's make the action and go ahead and save the PDF. The settings you use for your PDF will be used again, so make sure to set them to what you want to have. We can click the second column if you remember, which will ensure that Illustrator goes through the process step by step, and this will allow us to make changes to the PDF settings. One thing you might want to change would be the file location or, you know, the print document settings. But yeah, this is a handy action to have at the ready, and I'm going to add it into my 2020 workflow. Finally, another action that is based around transforming a shape or a design, and that is the rotation. Now I'm going to be making a new action as a keyboard shortcut as we did earlier, but this time I'm going to use Command and F7. Now to rotate your design or your object, simply come up to Object, Transform and then Rotate. I've made my actions for 90 degrees, but as I mentioned, you can check the second column in the Actions panel, and this will allow you to edit the rotational values whenever you want to perform this action. It's handy to be able to make these actions as keyboard shortcuts, and I hope you can see how this will save you time later down the line in your workflow. So now you know how to make actions, and you've heard about my 5 for my workflow in 2020, do make sure to check out the video at the end of this one to learn more crucial skills in Adobe Illustrator. Also, make sure to like and share my content on social media if you do want to help out the channel, and subscribe for weekly graphic design content. I hope you guys have a very positive end to the year, and of course until next time, design your future today. Peace.